All right, going to show you more evidence that the Luciferian heresy of a sinless perfection in this life, in this body of flesh, is a lie. Turn to Luke chapter 20, verses 34 to 38. And Jesus answering said unto them, The children of this world marry and are given in marriage, but they which shall be accounted worthy to obtain that world and the resurrection from the dead neither marry nor are given in marriage, neither can they die any more, for they are equal unto the angels, and are the children of God, being the children of the resurrection. And now that the dead are raised, even Moses showed at the bush, when he calleth the Lord the God of Abraham, and the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, for he is not a God of the dead, but of the living, for all live unto him. What do you have there? Well, right now you can experience physical death. Well, why do you experience physical death? Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Read Romans chapter 5, verses 12 to 19. You know, the reason why we experience physical death is because we have a sinful body of flesh. But what do you have here in Luke chapter 20, verse 34 to 38? At the resurrection of the dead, the rapture, obviously, you know, proper term would be resurrection, we can't die anymore. Why? Because at that point we're given an incorruptible body. We're no longer given an earthly, fleshly body. But right now our bodies are corrupt. That's why we experience physical death. You know, these sinless perfectionists, if they actually believe they're sinless, then they should not be experiencing any physical pain. They should not experience headaches. Heck, they shouldn't even have to go to sleep at night. Because the reason why you have to give your body so much maintenance and so much care is because it's a sinful, corrupt body of flesh. So just ask these sinless perfection people, have you ever had a headache? Have you ever had to go to sleep at night? Have you ever experienced pain? Have you ever experienced sorrow? If so, then you are not sinless. If humans could be sinlessly perfect, there should be people from hundreds of years ago still alive today because they maintain that sinless state. But they can't, because we experience death because our bodies are sinful. But the Luciferian heresy of sinless perfectionism denies that. Good comparison, compare this scripture with 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 42 to 49. Turn there. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 42 to 49. So also is the resurrection of the dead. It is sown in corruption, it is raised in incorruption. It is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is raised in power. It is sown a natural body, it is raised a spiritual body. There is a natural body and there is a spiritual body. And so it is written, the first man, Adam, was made a living soul. The last Adam was made a quickening spirit. Howbeit, that was not the first which is spiritual, not first which is spiritual, but that which is natural, and afterward that which is spiritual. The first man is of the earth, earthly. The second man is of the Lord from heaven. As is the earthly, such are they that are earth. All such are they also that are earthly, and as is the heavenly, such are they also that are heavenly. For as we have borne an image of the earthly, we shall also bear the image of the heavenly. Okay? You do not get an incorruptible, sinless body until the rapture, until the resurrection of the dead. That's why it's called the resurrection of the dead. Because when you die, your soul and spirit are redeemed, they go up to heaven, but your body of flesh is still corruptible. It goes down into the earth and is not redeemed till the rapture. You know, hence the resurrection, hence the title, Resurrection of the Dead. So just more clear evidence that the Luciferian heresy of sinless perfectionism is that, a heresy, a lie from the devil. It's nothing more than just Satan's lie of ye shall be as gods in Genesis 3:5 repackaged, because you're trying to basically be sinless like God. But you experience physical death because, why? You have a sinful body. Just compare Luke chapter 20 verses 34 to 38 with 1 Corinthians 15 verses 42 to 49, and more evidence that the Luciferian heresy of sinless perfectionism is a lie from Satan. So, just wanted to show you guys that. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all the brethren. Goodbye.